Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to the Majors of Central Industry class, that is your open elective subject. In the previous class, we had the discussion of calculation of missing frequency based on arithmetic mean only. Now I will take you all for your next kind of question, that is called grouped series. Which one? That was your group data or continuous series. So in case of group data or continuous series, what is the formula for mean? So once again, we have the three methods in arithmetic mean for group data, like that ungrouped data or discrete series. Previous method, we have the two methods for arithmetic mean. Now for group data or continuous series, both are same. For this, what are the different type of methods are there? Three methods are there. So we'll first write that arithmetic mean. We'll discuss first arithmetic mean. What is arithmetic mean? So the formula for arithmetic mean, first method is direct method. Which method? Direct method, x bar equal to summation of f into m divided by n. Clear? Number two, that is a shortcut method. In this method, x bar equal to a plus summation of f d divided by n. This formula is exactly your previous method. Which one? The discrete series method and this formula in continuous, both are same shortcut. And come to the point of third one. Which one? Step deviation method. Step deviation method, x bar equal to a plus summation of f d dash, this symbol is for dash, divided by n into I. I will repeat once again, x bar equal to a plus summation of ft is dash divided by n into I. Then what is this m frequency? F means frequency, m means midpoint. Just you all you note that one. F means frequency, m means what actually m means? M is midpoint. And if you go to the next one, in this n is not total frequency, I think all you know above already. Then what is a here? Assumed mean, same previous method. Frequency, d means deviation. I will explain you in the solution. N is frequency total. Then a is once again same arithmetic mean, sorry, assumed mean. F is frequency. What is d dash? D dash is like this. D dash equal to d divided by c. What is d dash? D dash is compared to d divided by c. Then n is total frequency. I is width of the class. I will explain this one in the solution. This was the arithmetic mean. Now I will take you the group data or continuous series median. Now what is median? Means median formula. So median equal to L. L means lower limit of the median class. Which class? There are many classes are there. Out of that, median class lower limit. So L divided by 2 minus CF divided by F into I. So L plus N by 2 minus CF divided by F into I. This was the median. So L is lower limit of median class, N is total frequency divided by 2, CF cumulative frequency preceding to median class. Which class is the median class? It's a previous number cumulative frequency. That is the cumulative frequency preceding to median class. Simple frequency, F means simple frequency, I is once again width of the class. Then move to the third method. Which one? Mode now. Mode equal to L plus delta 1 divided by delta 1 plus delta 2 into I. What is this L? L is out of the given number of classes. Example 0 to 10, 10 to 20, like that. Classes are given. Out of those given classes, which class is the mode class? That class lower limit. Delta 1 means which class is mode class, its preceding number and the mode class difference. We will give you that. The solution is clear to you all. So delta 1 means mode class and preceding class difference. Once again, both are same here. What is delta 2? Mode class frequency, its next class frequency difference. That is delta 2. Mode class frequency, its next class frequency difference. I is once again with after class. So you have these are the three calculations that you need to do in the continuous series. Remember, in arithmetic mean only you have the three methods. Come to the point of arithmetic mean first. If they are asking in exam, calculate the arithmetic mean under diet method, you apply this method. If they are asking compute the arithmetic mean by using shortcut, use this one. If it is shortcut method, use this one. There is no the information given to you in exam. Which method that you have to use? If it is not given, then you use out of these three methods one best. So if a choice given to you to select the formula, the best method is which one? Very simple method is shortcut method. You should use the shortcut method for computation of arithmetic mean. If it is not mentioned in the problem, which method that you have to use, then you need to use the which method? Direct method, right? So come to the point of medians, you don't have any the alternative formula for this. This was the one formula, use this one. There is no method in the median. And you have the median, some methods are there that you neglect that one. So I will use this only with this formula for computation of mode. So if the question is mode, use this formula. So you have the three methods. First of all, I will use one by one. First I will compute the arithmetic mean by using three methods. Then we'll go for the all the three mean, median, mode in one problem, right? So first I will solve you all of these three mean by using three formula and median only one formula, mode one formula. One problem I will solve. Then later we'll go for the combined solution, right? So I will solve the first column based on this mean, right? So first I will go with the mean calculation. The question number 12 over. I will go to the question number 13. Question is like this. Calculate arithmetic mean using all methods. So see, I give you calculate arithmetic mean by using all methods means what? Direct method, shortcut method and step deviation method, right? So now all methods have to adapt now. The question is like this. Takes 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, last to 40 to 50. Which number last one? Last number is 40 to 50. Now use the frequency now. Frequency is like this, 2, 3, 4, 1, last 5. In case of computation of the continuous series or group data, no need to arrange the variable because always the classes are given. Classes are given or class intervals are given in the form of ascending only or descending. No problem for computation of this arithmetic mean. Clear? So, solution now. Now, solution I will go with the direct method first. Which method? Direct method solution. Clear? So I will use this formula first. Direct method. Use the same question. X 0 to 10, 10 to 20, continue up to 40 to 50. So frequency 2, 3, 4, 1, then 5. First of all, you have to find for computation of mean for this method, direct method M we need. We need what actually? M. So we need the M for computation of which method? Direct method. So M. So M means what? Lower limit of the class plus upper limit of the class. This was lower limit of the class. What is lower limit of the class? Right? Lower limit of the class. In a class interval, the lower number or left number is known as the lower limit of the class. This was for upper limit. What is upper limit? In a class interval, the right side number or the higher number is known as upper limit. So these are the lower limits and these are the upper limits. Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So 0 plus 10 divided by 2 means how much? 5. 10 plus 20 divided by 2, 15. So what was the difference here? 10, 10. So you make the 10 increase now. 5 next 15. You add these two. Divide by 2, 25. Otherwise increase the 10 number here. 35, 45. Otherwise you do 40 plus 50 divided by 2, 45 only. 40 plus 50, 90. 90 divided by 2, how much? 45. Otherwise, what is the class interval here? 10. So you use that 10 increase in the value. Anyone? Method that you have to find. So I think the m is clear to all of you. Now multiply f into m now. What is f into m? 5 into 2 or 2 into 5, 10. 3, 15 is 45. 4, 25 is 100. 1, 35 is 35. Next, 5 into 45, 2, 25. Take the total of this one and this one. This was the total of n and this was the total of fm. So 2 plus 3, 5 plus 4, 9 plus 10, 15. And you add these 2 to 25 plus 35. It was 260, 360, then 400, 415. So all you check that whether the total is correct or wrong. And then move to the formula of arithmetic mean direct method. Which method? Direct method formula. Use this formula. So x bar equal to summation of f into m divided by n. F into m is how much? 415, here 415 f into m. What is n? 15. So now you find that 415 divided by how much? 415 divided by 15. The value comes 27.66666. So use the 27.67. So this was the solution for which method? Direct method. If you are using the direct method, so here m you have to find, then fm. Then use the formula, you will get the simple for computation of arithmetic mean by using a direct method. Now I will use the which method now? Shortcut method. This method, shortcut method. For shortcut method also we need, I will go with the shortcut method. Right? For shortcut method also we need the m. We need the midpoint for shortcut method also. For computing the shortcut method we need the m. So now shortcut method. Right, so x is given the problem, I taken f from the question, then it is computed now, lower limit plus upper limit by 2, it was m. Now, move to the solution of this by using this one, right. So first find the d, what is d? D means assumed mean, what is d? D means assumed mean. So assumed mean, you take the small number, first number in the m, whatever the m value, that is a median point, middle point is there, the middle point first number you have to take in order to avoid the negative. So first 5, 5 minus 5, what is this d? D equal to m minus a. What is a here? A is taken 5. So m minus a, m is all mid points, minus a means what? 5 is taken, 5 height is taken, smallest number, right? First number you take always as a assumed mean in a midpoint. So 5 minus 5, 0, m is 10, 10 is 15, 15 minus a is 5 here, 10. Same, 25 minus 5, 20, 35 minus 5, 30, 45 minus 5, 40. Now you multiply f into d, what you have to multiply f into d? So f is here, d is here, 2 into 0, 0, 3 into 10, 30, 4 into 20, 80, 1 into 30, 30, 5 into 40, 200. So take the total of 30 plus 88, 110, 140, 340 is the total. Right? What is the formula for your shortcut method? This formula. So I will use the formula here. So x bar equal to a plus summation of f divided by n. A is how much taken? 5. Plus, what is your fd? Summation of fd? Fd total is 340. Right, divided by n is 15, so 5 plus, now you find that 340 divided by 15, how much? 15, so it comes to 22.6666, so I will take 22.67, then 5 plus 22.67 is 27.67. So if you use the shortcut method also, your answer is same. If you refer the previous method, that method becomes 27.666 or 667. If I use the same question shortcut method, so it was same. I think the solution is clear to all of you. Now I will take you to the next method. Is it clear to all of you? I hope that it is clear. If it is still doubt, call me and rectify your questions, right? Your problems are your doubts. Next, move to the third method. Which one? Step deviation method. For step deviation method also, up to the midpoint, we need the same. So D also we need now. So if I go to the step deviation method now, which method? Step deviation method. So X and F is given the problem. I will go to the text to take you step deviation. Remember now, X is given the problem, F is also given the problem. So M will be computed now, lower limit plus upper limit by 2, same. D, how it is computed? In the M number, first number is called A, that is assumed to be A, that is all numbers minus 5. All these M numbers, subtract the 5 there. So you will get the D. Now after this, what you have to do? D dash. What is D dash? D dash equal to D divided by C. C means 10. What is this 10? 10 is the difference. Class width is 10. If you take the class width, 10 is 10 only. If it is class width 5, example 0 to 5, 5 to 10, then you take the 5 here. If it is 0 to 20, 20 to 40, then you take the 20 is the difference here, 20 divided by 20. So what is D dash then? D dash equal to D value divided by whatever the class interval is, that is your C. So now 0 divided by 10. D means 0. 0 by 10 means 0. 10 is the D. D means 10. 10 divided by 10 means 1. 20 divided by 10 means 2, 3, 4. All these numbers, B numbers divided by 10 number. So you will get the 1, 2, 3, 4, 30 by 10, 40 by 10. So you will get this one. Now you multiply F into D dash. What you have to do now? F into D dash. F is 2, D dash is 0. 2 into 0, 0. 3 into 1, 3. 4 into 2, 8. Then 1 into 3, 3. 4 into 5, 20. Add all 23 plus 8, 31 plus 3, 24. So I think it was, so not 24, 23, 31, 34. Total is 34. Now use the same number in the this third method. So we use that here only. What is A? CLA is how much? 5 plus. What is your summation of FD dash? FD dash here 34. 34 divided by 15 into what is I? I means width. Width is how much here? Difference 10. Then you simplify this one. 5 plus, see, 34 divided by 15 into 10. So it comes 22.67. You just do it. How I did this one? 34 divided by 15 into 10. Otherwise, 34 into divided by 10 into 15. 10. 34 into 10 divided by 15, any type you have to do, you will get the 22.67. The ninth answer is total is how much? 27.67. So if you refer the any method out of the three methods, you will get the same answer, that is 27.67. I think I proved this by using this problem. So you have the three methods for computation of mean. The one method is, which method? The first method is direct method. Second one is shortcut method. Third one is step deviation method. I hope that I cleared all the three methods. Now onwards, I will move with you only one method. Which one? Direct method. If in exam, if they are asking specific shortcut or step deviation, use the same method that I given one problem to you, then you use it. Right? So now I will give you one question as a homework, that is question number 14. By using that question number 14, you solve all these three methods and send the answer to me. So this was the question number 14 now. What is question number 14? Once again same. Calculate the arithmetic mean using all methods. All methods means total how many methods are there? So you have only how many methods? Three methods. All three methods that you have to use. Right? So first I will use your classes. The first heading is classes. Next heading is frequencies. Right? classes means x, frequency means f, right? Classes are x, so then frequency means f. So 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25. So how many frequencies are there? Sorry, how many classes are there? All if you are to observe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 numbers are there, 5 classes are there, and each class depends how much here now, 5. Remember, d dash when you are finding d dash d divided by how much now? 5, because of it is 5. And here I means how much? 5 in this method. So frequency 8, 9, 11, 10, last one is 9. So this question number 14, it is assigned to you all. You solve the problem by using all three methods of the mean and send the standard copy to me, right? So most of you still not sending the previous answers, especially voice side. We will take the if anyone is not sending the answer, we will take the noting. I'm just taking the note of that one, those who are not sending the answers, right? So okay, this was the solution of the question number 14. 13 base is 14, right? So now I will take you the next method is computation of median. Now which method? Median calculation. Which method calculation? Median. In median only we have only one method. There is no the different methods, right? Only one method that you have to find and you have to use, right? So I'll take you the calculation of median now. Question number 15. Which one? Question number 15. Find out median, right? The question is find out a median. The median for question is like this: 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, last 40 to 50. Then frequency 2, 1, 3, 4, 2. So this was the question. So based on this, you need to attempt the calculation of median. Question number 15. Solution. So x, that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, the last number is 40 to 50. So this was the 40 to 50 last. Then you find the frequency now. Frequency is given the problem itself. So 2, 1, 3, 4, 2, right? 2, 1, 3, 4, 2. Now you need to do by using which one now? Median you have to find, right? So for the computation of median, the formula of median is like this. First of all, I will write you the formula. Roughly I will show you the formula. The formula is like this. What is median formula? Median equal to L plus N divided by 2 minus CF divided by F into I. This was the formula, right? So for this, what we need? We need the CF. That is enough. For computation of median, CF is enough for us. Because F is given the problem itself. That is f is there, its total is your, this total is f, 6, 10, 12, that is n, 2 plus 3 plus 6, 10, 12, 12 is the n, so we got the n here, and frequency means these are numbers only, frequency comes, I means width of the class, difference of the class is width, only we need the cf now. So how to find the cf? I think I already shown you in the previous method. So first take the 2 as it is 2. 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, these two always same. Now, I will use the right formula. So, to explain you the formula, median, the median formula is like this, median equal to L plus N divided by 2 minus CF whole divided by N into I. What is this? ME means median. I will give you the notations. Just all you have to write these notations. What is here ME? ME equal to median. What is L? Lower limit of which class? Median class. Which one? Lower limit of median class. What is N? N is total frequency. Then what is the CF? Cumulative frequency preceding to medium class. See, cumulative frequency preceding means previous to medium class. I'll explain how this one is taken. N is clear here, both N are same, right? Not this is actually N, this is F actually. N by 2 minus F divided by F. What is F? F, simple frequency. Simple frequency. Then what is I? I equal to width. Width of class. So these are the values. Now identify this one. So you need to find this number first L. To find the L, we have done small formula. I will show you now. After this, you write that. How to find this L? L is the low limit of medium class. So it means 0 to 10 to 40 to 50, total 5 classes are there. Out of 5 classes, one class is exactly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 classes are there. Out of 5 classes, one class is your median class, right? Which one? That one. To find the median class, out of 5, one class is median. To identify that median class, we need to use one small formula. That is like this. Median class equal to n divided by 2. What is the formula? What is that formula? Very simple, n divided by 2, median class formula. So n is how much here? 12. 12 divided by 2 means how much comes? 6. Now 6th item. You check in the 6th item in the CF. 6 exactly is here, 6 only. If it is example 5, 2, 3, 5 and 10, then your 6 comes in the 10 number. Because it is more than 5 to 10 here means it comes here. But it is exactly 6 is given. So this was your which class? This was your median class. Which class? Median class. I think it is clear. Value 6 comes. Exactly, you find the previous method you are finding that I find the CF. Same type you have to find the CF. 6. 6 is there, exactly 6 is comes here now. So this here we have the referred to your pitch class and median class. Now identify all these items now. So I think it is visible. So now I am using this formula. Notations are here, the value is here. What is L? Lower limit of median class. So this was your median class. It's a lower limit means this one lower limit, this one is upper limit. What is your median class lower limit? 20. Use this formula. What is n by 2? N by 2 means n is 12 divided by 2. So it is already computed here. N divided by 2 how much? 6. It is already computed here. Use the same. Minus. What is the CF? Cumulative frequency preceding means previous to median class. Cumulative frequency median class, 6 is the cumulative frequency of median class, it's a preceding frequency. Preceding means which one? 3. See, cumulative frequency preceding to median class, which this was your median class. Median class cumulative frequency is 6, it's a preceding. Preceding means 3 minus 3 divided by. What is your simple frequency of median class? Which class? Simple frequency means all these are simple frequency. Which frequency we need? Simple frequency of the median class. See, this was once again median class. 3 is called what? Frequency, basic frequency. Simple frequency. 3 is the median class. Simple frequency is 3. Then what is this I? Width of class. Width means this class. Don't take the other classes. Only median class width. How much median class width is there? Width of median class. Which class? This was your median class 20 to 30. It's width. Width means 20 to 30. Difference is 10 into 10. Simplify this one. 20 plus 6 minus 3. 3 divided by 3 into 10. So 3 cancel. 20, 3 cancel into simplify. 3 divided by 3 into 10. If you find 20, it comes 10 here. So total answer is 30. So 30 is the value of your which one? The median. I think I hope that this was clear to all of you. What is the answer for your medium? This was the answer of medium. Remember these notations. I will explain you once again. To find the first L, what you have to find? You need to use this very small formula, n divided by 2. That is n is 12 divided by 2, 6. And 6 you identify the cumulative frequency. Where it comes? 6. If it is like not exactly 6, if it is 5 here, then 5 to next 10. Between 5 to 10, your 6 comes, then in this area is your median area. Right? So you use here now median. L is lower limit, 20. What is n by 2? 12 divided by 2, 6. What is your CF? Cumulative frequency preceding to median class. Median class CF is preceding. Then what is simple frequency? Simple frequency means what? Median class, this frequency, simple frequency. Then width means I means width of the class. Width of the class means these two difference. Width. Don't take other classes, only these two classes. That is your L. Is that clear? So I hope that this one is clear. Now I will assign you the same question, that is the computation of median based on the same structure, right? So that is your question number 16. Right? All you write this question number 16, use the same method and you send the answer to me. I hope that this computation of median is clear to each one of you. Okay. The question is like this. Find out the median 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 3, 4, 9, 8, 7. Now, this was the question number 16. This question number 16 is assigned to all of you. You need to find the median and send the scan copy to me without fail. It is mandatory. Right? So this was all about the calculation of median. Now I will take you all for next method, page 1 mode. Right? So now I will take you question number 17 now. 17 is your calculation of mode 1. Question number 17. Calculation of mode 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30. What is frequency? Frequency is 3, 4, 9, 8, 3, 2. This was your the question for mode. Then solution. There is no different method for mode. Use the same method. 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, last 25 to 30. What is your 3, 4, 9, 8, 3, 2. Now, how to find the mode? So I will write it first here now, the formula of mode. Actually, no need to write this, the variables given in the problem. Without that, it is possible. Mode equal to formula like this, L plus delta 1 divided by delta 1 minus delta 2 into I. So MO means mode. Yes, MO means mode. What is L? Once again, lower limit of mode class. Which class? Lower limit of mode class. What is delta 1? Delta 1 equal to difference between mode class frequency, short wave rate, difference between mode class frequency and its previous class frequency. I will write it here shortly. Frequency, I will read you. Difference between mode class frequency and its preceding class frequency. What is delta 2? Reverse. Difference between mode class frequency and next class frequency. Which one is your mode class? That frequency, it's for next frequency. What is here I? Again, width of mode class. Width of fixed class, mode class. So I will assign the same method here now. What is mode? What is L? L is lower limit of mode class. Which class is a mode class? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 6. 0 to 5 to 25 to 30, 6 classes are there. Out of 6 class, which class is your mode class? If you refer the previous method of median, so n by 2, median class, how it is computed? N divided by 2, that is computed in CF, then it is marked. Now there is no such kind of a separate formula for identifying the L here in case of mode. Very simple, you check the highest frequency 3, 4, 9, 8, 3, 2. Highest frequency is how much? 9. This was your mode. Remember, your highest frequency is this one. Your mode answer comes between these two only. 10 to 15 only your answer comes, median, sorry, mode. Like in median also same. Whatever your class comes, within that only your answer comes, mode. So how it is identified? Highest frequency. 9 is there. If one more 9 is there, then the formula of this one is not worked out. Then I think you solved a previous method, that is 3 median minus 2 mean applied. I will show you that one later. So highest frequency is 9 here. Just you think that one, this one only. Highest frequency only once is the 9. So this area is your which area? Mode area. What is your mode area? Low limit 10 to 15. 10 is low limit, 15 is upper limit. 10 is the mode class. Its value is how much? 10. That is 10. Then what is your delta 1? Delta 1 means C. Difference between mode class. Mode class frequency is 9. Mode class frequency and its preceding class frequency. That is, mode class frequency is 9 and its preceding class frequency difference. That is 9 minus 4. What is 9 minus 4? Then what is delta 1? Once again same. 9 minus 4 plus. What is delta 2? Mode class frequency, its next class frequency. Mode class is 9 frequency. Its next class frequency 8. 9 minus 8. 9 minus 8. You have to write directly here. 9 minus 4 is 5. 9 minus 4 is 5. Directly you have to write. But this was the first problem. So I written this number figures here only. So what is your I? I is width of the class. What is your width of the class? Your width of the class is how much here? 10 minus 15 is 5. 5 is the value. So 10 plus 9 minus 5. 9 minus 4, 5. Divided by 9 minus 4, 5. Plus is there. 9 minus 8, 1. Into how this 5 comes between these two difference, right? So I hope that this was clear. 10, 5 divided by total 6, 5 divided by 6 into 5 is there. So 5 25 by 6, you have to find 10 plus 5 divided by 6 into 5. What you have to do? 5 divided by 6 into 5. You will get the answer is 4.1666. So this was 4.17. So answer is 14.17 mode. So I think this setup is clear. What is your L? Lower limit, how it is computed? Highest frequency. Its lower limit is L. What is delta 1? Highest frequency minus basic frequency, delta 1. 9 minus 4 is 5. See, 9 minus 4 is 5. Again, delta 1 means 9 minus 4, 5. What is delta 2? Highest frequency, its next frequency. 9 minus 8 is 1. That is 1 here. Then I means width of the class, 10 to 15, 5 comes in. Simplify, this was the answer for your mode, right? So I hope that this calculation of mode is clear. All you have to write these notations, very important, exam also you have to write. Now I will take you question number 18, that is assigned to you. You have to find the question number 18. So thereby I will give you the, in this class 3 questions are given. Question number, which one? 18. Question number 18. Calculate the mode. Question is like this: 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Frequency 3, 4, 9, 8, 10, 9, 7. So this was the entire. If you think that highest frequency is 10, only once is there. So this area is your mode area. 10 minus this one is delta 1, 10 minus this one is delta, 10 minus 9 is delta 2. Just you find that one. I think I cleared in this class computation of mean 3 methods and I solved one problem and assigned to you one. After that, separately mean calculation, separately mode calculations. In the next class, what I will do? I will do that calculation of mean and median mode in one problem. One problem only they will ask in exam. If separately they will ask you, no problem. Then if it is asked 3 in one question, that I will solve you in the next class. Hope so this the entire class is clear to each one of you. And send the answer that the 3 questions I have. Just send me a scan copies. Thank you. Thank you very much. Bye bye.